nanoHUB-U, online instruction.
Hey everyone, welcome to lecture 3.11. So we're still talking about MEEP, and we just explained how to create a straight waveguide, and now we're going to see what happens when you bend the waveguide. So here's basically a modified version of our original waveguide structure, but now we've doubled the size of the lattice in the y direction. And so if you look at this geometry here, you can see before basically we had a geometry that was like this. So it's essentially like the first half at the top, but then we're adding this bend. And so we have to double the height so we have enough room for it to fully bend around. And then we're basically setting two blocks in the upper left, creating this block, and then we're creating another block over here using the same coordinate system as before, of course, with just double the size and y direction. And then that's the geometry that we get at the end of the day when we pick that. We set the PML layers just like we did before. The source is slightly modified just in terms of the exact wavelength that we're looking at. And then the run function is almost the same as the previous example. And so now we can actually create a movie of what happens with the propagation of the light. And so you can kind of see it's starting to happen now. The source is turning on, and so the light is actually coupling into this waveguide and it's propagating down. However, when it reaches this corner, it's a very sharp corner, so a lot of it radiates away from there. Nonetheless, some of it is able to make it around the bend and start propagating down. But you can see that there's actually a lot of attenuation happening because of that bend. And the reason is very simple, because a very sharp bend breaks the index guiding condition that the angle has to be greater than the critical angle for wave guiding. And so since we broke that, the amount of wave guiding we get around this bend is actually not that high. And we can actually set up our system at that point, once we've seen that's happening, to measure like what is the transmission as a function of frequency. So this is a modification to the existing file and geometry that we already have. And so the idea is that first we would look at like what is the transmission in the absence of a bend. And so we create this no bend condition. And then we also create like a flux in the presence of the bend as well. Okay, so this is basically allowing us to have like a switch that has two different geometries based on whether or not we have that bend. And then in both cases, we can compute a transmitted flux. And you can see the difference is just that the flux region that we're creating is centered at different location based on whether or not we have the bend present. And then, of course, we can also calculate a reflected flux in a similar fashion. But the overall result looks something like this. You can see basically the transmission around the bend is very frequency dependent. It drops a lot as you go to the kind of this critical frequency, about 0.15, goes back up again. So of course the loss also peaks exactly where the transmission is at a minimum. But interestingly, the reflection itself is not as strongly dependent on the frequency. So that tells us something about the bend that maybe we wouldn't have guessed right away. So basically the key trade-off is between radiation at that corner and transmission. So in the next lecture, we'll talk in more detail about what are some other examples in MEEP that we can use to understand it.